morning, students. Today we are going to start with the chapter My Childhood. So open up your book, please. My Childhood. Open up your book. Now, My Childhood. About whose childhood or about whom it is going to talk about? What the chapter is about? The chapter is about our former president, Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam, and who was a great personality. Why he was a great personality? Because he was also a scientist. And it's just because of this reason that he was also called as missile man. So as a missile man, it means that he was able to make scientific inventions which were quite helpful in the development of our country. And it is just because of this reason that he is remembered forever in the history of our country, not only as a president, but as a great scientist also, who has worked a lot in order to provide strength to the part of arms and ammunition of our country that is quite helpful in protecting our country from our enemies. So what this childhood, as I have told you that this chapter is about childhood of Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam. So from this chapter, it is not actually a complete chapter, but actually what it is actually taken up from that of, it is an excerpt from his autobiography. What is an autobiography? Autobiography is a book written by a person giving an account of his life, incident of the incident of his life, or the experiences of the person. And when he wanted to disclose his life, when he wanted to explain his life to other people. So this is what, as this is excerpt means, this is just a part of writing. Okay, excerpt means it is just a part of writing which has been taken from his famous book, that is Wings of Fire. Maybe I can ask you that how many of you have read it? If you have read it, you must have known that how resolute this personality was, how dedicated, how hardworking APJ Abdul Kalam was since his childhood. Right. Okay, so Panika, you have read? I hope that any one of you must have read. If you have not read, so then just note it in your diary that in the next summer vacation, you are going to read it. Because good books, they always give an exercise to your mind. They always refresh your thoughts. They always provide you with new ideas. They always provide you with new experiences. And you know that all the problems that human beings, they are going through. It is said that one should read only good books because all the problems which the human beings, they are going through, they can find the solution in them. Because it is only mentioned and prescribed in the books that all the problems which other people have gone through and they have given the solution. Right? So this excerpt is taken from his autobiography, Wings of Fire. Now, what it explains, it doesn't explain about his complete life, no. Like we have read in the chapter, Albert Einstein, in which we have studied that how Albert Einstein, since his childhood, he has grown to a great scientist. But here he has not mentioned that how he has rose to the world fame, but actually he has mentioned that during his childhood, what kind of obstacles he has faced. Because as a young child or as a child, he has faced number of discriminations because he was a Muslim. And as he was a Muslim, but India, of course, is a secular country where we are respecting and maintain the dignity of all the religions. But in spite of that, at some of the places, some people think and you can say feel disdainfully or with an insulting image in their mind about Muslims. it is just because of this reason that he has faced discrimination from her, from the wife of his science teacher, who was not allowing him to sit in her kitchen and enjoy food with his with her husband. Why? Because he was a Muslim, and his science teacher, he was purely a Brahmin, right? But as you know that the seeds of greatness, they are sowed since childhood only. You know that even Einstein, he has shown his greatness since childhood because he was playing with mechanical toys during his childhood. When he started studying, he was interested in mathematics as well as science, or especially you can say physics. And he was not studying any other or any other subject. So similarly, in case of APJ Abdul Kalam, his greatness can be seen right from the roots where his childhood has been, it has been started. From his parents, he has learned great, you can say he has learned great virtues of life. How to be kind to others, and why to be helpful to others, how to maintain graciousness in your character. And he has learned all these qualities from his father and mother. And he is always saying that he is indebted towards his parents because he has learned these qualities from them. And APJ Abdul Kalam, he has, as he wanted his, you can say, his higher education, his father was quite understandable to this thing that he wanted higher education, and if he needed some higher education, he has to leave his native place, because even a seagull has to leave his nest in order to earn food or in order to find food for the young one. And it is just because of this reason that he has left his parental home and parental city, and he has gone to another city in order to achieve higher education. And moreover, he has the feeling of acceptance too. How he has the feeling of acceptance? It is because of the reason that he knew that he was a child of, you can say, or he was having very normal, you can say, he was having very normal looks. And it is because of this reason that he is never complaining to God. He knew that he is not so, you can say, that he is short-heighted also. But he has never complained. So it means that this chapter is also teaching us the lesson that we should accept whatever the God has given us. Whatever the God has given us is always right for our life. So, he is talking about his childhood, and he has also told in this chapter that he has friends specially from Brahmin origin. And all his friends, they are specially from Brahmin origin, and there was not any kind of discrimination at the place where he has spent his childhood. So he was quite living in affection with his friends. But one day when a new teacher entered into to his school, and he has told Abdul Kalam, because he was a Muslim boy, to go and sit at the last seat. Why? Because he has seen that he was wearing that Muslim cap that was discriminating him from that Brahmin boys. And being a Hindu also, he was not able to digest this, that why this boy or why this Muslim, he was sitting along with other Brahmin boys at the front seat. So what he has told that boy to go at the last and sit there. This was really, you can say, heartbreaking episode for him. And ultimately from his science teacher Subramaniam Iyer, he has learned an important lesson of life, that if you want to break the obstacles, you have to face many kind of bars in the society, and he must have his bent of mind in the way that he should always be ready to break these bars. And this is how, and this is what he has taught in this chapter, that it is not easy to break you can say the bars that has been set up by a society. One has to face many kind of, you can say, obstacles, hurdles, and face different kind of, you can say, discrimination in order to overcome these kind of bars and obstacles in our life. And this is what means the life of such great people. It is totally exemplified. Why it is exemplified? It is exemplified with number of such episodes, which are always a lesson for us. We always learn a lesson from their life. So here lies the greatness in their character, that these people, they are always, you can say, a learning lesson for complete mankind. And this is how, from this chapter, we will learn number of values, we will read about his life, and we will come to know that it is not easy to achieve such kind of fame. It requires dedication, it requires perseverance, it requires hard work, and moreover, strength in your thoughts that will ultimately bloom out into success. So let us start with the chapter, My Childhood. So with you, I'm sharing the screen where the chapter is. Now it is going to be visible on your screen. Let me shift it to the other side. Yes. My childhood. Can you think of any scientists who have also been statesmen? Statesmen means the person who are in power. Yes. Have you ever thought of any person? Yes. Few persons are there, but mainly we are in our era, we are remembering APJ Abdul Kalam, Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam, who was of course a scientist and was also the president of India. Now, APJ Abdul Kalam, whose projects in space, defense, and nuclear technology guided India into the 21st century, became our 11th president in 2002. Yes, so he has turned out to be our 11th president in 2002, and he has guided India in various different kind of projects which were helpful to strengthen the defense, arms and ammunition, as well as nuclear technology of our country. And it is just because of this reason that today India stands, you can say, stands single or stands separate from other nations, and he has made a mark in the world, that yes, we also have power, and they are making their enemies afraid. In his autobiography, Wings of Fire, he speaks of his childhood. As I told you, that this excerpt, it has been taken from his autobiography, that is Wings of Fire. And this is just an excerpt which has been taken from this chapter. So let us start this chapter. I was born into a middle class Tamil family in the island town of Rameshwaram in the erstwhile Madras. Okay, erstwhile Madras means earlier which was called as Madras. So what he is saying that where he was born. He was born in a middle class family. It means that he was not born with a silver spoon. Silver spoon means having rich heritage, but he belonged to a middle class family where in the Strait of Rameshwaram, which was situated in former Madras. My father, Jainulabdin, had neither much formal education nor much wealth. Despite these disadvantages, he possessed great innate means present since birth. He possessed great innate wisdom and a true generosity of spirit. What he's saying that his father, what was the name of his father? Underline it in your book. The name of his father was Jainulabdin. He was, what are the qualities of his father? He had neither much formal education. You know that in older times, only few people, they get higher education. But you know, whatever they are studying, it was so valuable that they can make great calculations, you can say, without using calculator, and ultimately whatever they were studying, it was quite beneficial for them. So, and he said he did not have formal education, and during that time people were only studied till 5th, till 8th, till 10th, few people till plus 2, and just only a few, they are the few people, they are, you can say, getting higher education and reaching higher rank. So Jainuladdin, his father, he was also not, or he has not attained much formal education, and moreover, being a middle class family, he has not collected or he has not gathered much wealth. It means that this is the reason why he belongs to a middle class family. Despite these disadvantages, yes, of course, these are of course disadvantages, he says, which his father, he was suffering from, but he possessed great innate wisdom. Wisdom means sense of righteousness, having great quality to do the justice, to feel what is right and what is wrong. So what he is saying, but he possessed great innate wisdom and a true generosity of spirit. Generosity of spirit means what it means? That he possessed great innate wisdom. He possessed great wisdom. He was having sense of righteousness. He knew what is right and what are the good qualities which are required for a human being to live a life of good character. And true generosity of spirit, it means that he was quite generous in his nature. Generous means to help others who are actually in need. So whatever the ways he was capable of doing this thing, he was always doing to help those people. So he had an ideal helpmate in my mother, Ashyama. So his wife, whose name was Ashyama, she was also a great or a compatible companion to his father. Why compatible companion? Because she is also endowed with those qualities which his father had. She is also having those qualities, and it is because of this reason that they both were forming a perfect match with each other. So what was the name of his mother? The name of his mother was Ashyama, and the name of the father was Jainuladdin. So I do not recall the exact number of people she fed every day, but I'm quite certain that far more outsiders ate with us than all the members of our own family put together. So what he is saying? He's saying, see, you know, this was considered to be a great tradition by your grandparents. Of course, not in these times, that they used to feed any person who is coming to your house. If somebody is coming to your house, suppose for work, they would never let that person go without tea or having some refreshment in the form of sherbet or in the form of cold drink. Older times, you don't have cold drink to serve, but they always ask the person to have lunch with you, to have food or to eat food and then go. Even all the relatives coming to your house, they are not going without eating food. And it was the tradition of those times that people used to feed others, and they feel that their karma is complete with this act. And moreover, if any beggar comes, or if any person who is quite poor, he is coming to their door, ringing the bell, they would never let the person go out without having anything. They can be able to give some coins, and moreover, they would definitely ask, do you want to have food? And they find it quite satisfactory. Satisfaction they get, and moreover, they feel that this is the fulfillment of their good karma. And it is because of this reason that these people, they feed number of persons in their family. And this was the tradition in their family also. So what he is saying? He is saying that he was helping number of people who are coming in their families. And because they are coming in their families, So he said, I don't know the exact number of people who are coming to our house daily. The number of people who are coming to their house for getting fed, they are actually greater than the number of persons in the family. It means that her mother Ashiyamma, she also believes in the goodness of charity, to be kind to others, and she is a good planner also. Moreover, she is cooking more food than required because she knew that number of people would come to their house who would be in need of food, and they would serve them. So I'm quite certain that far more outsiders ate with us than all the members of our own family put together. So what she's saying that number of people who are coming to their house, they are far more greater. Means the actual number of people who are eating food with us, they are quite large than that of the number of actual family members. So this paragraph, it has given a complete view of the family. It means that his parents, where his grassroots are lying. His father, Jainulabdin, who was having greatness of character. Mother Ashiyamma, who was also kind and generous in nature. And it is because of these qualities that of his parents, that there are greater number of people who are eating food in their house than that of actual members of the family. So since his childhood, he has learned this quality from his parents, to help others, to be kind to others, and to serve others. So coming up to next paragraph, I was one of many children, a short boy with rather undistinguished looks. So here he has great power of acceptance as well as power of admitting the reality. He knew that there are a number of brothers and sisters in the family, and I was quite short boy. Short boy means short heighted. He was not so tall in height and rather undistinguished looks. Undistinguished looks means that he was not having, you can say, special kind of, you can say, attractive looks. Undistinguished means it was not gathering attraction of anyone. Undistinguished looks, he knew that he was not having, and born to tall and handsome parents. But his parents, they were quite tall and they were handsome too. We lived in our ancestral house, which was built in the middle of the 19th century. So now he is going to tell us about his ancestral house, where it was built and what kind of house it was. So he was saying that he was living in the ancestral house, which was built in 19th century, middle of 19th century. It was a fairly large pakka house. Of course, it was a pakka house, which was made of limestone and bricks. What it was made up of? It was made up of limestone and bricks. And on the moss street in Rameshwara, on the moss street means in their street, they situated a mosque. Mosque means it is a praying place or place to say prayers for the Muslims, worship place for Muslims. So, in this street, they situated a mosque where their house was situated in Rameshwaram. My austere father, what is the meaning of austere? Austere means a person who feels that basic necessities are important, but all the luxuries, they are not so important. It means that he is of simple as well as strict nature, who feels what is necessary in life, and giving importance only to necessary things in life. So, his father, who was austere in nature and used to avoid all inessential comforts and luxuries. As I told you, that his father, he was so, you can say, focused upon the requirements of life. who has never denied to fulfill the basic requirements of the children, but he has never paid attention to fulfill, or he has never felt its importance to fulfill or to provide luxuries. So this is the reason he was having a normal childhood. However, all necessities were provided for in terms of food, medicine or clothes. And actually, all necessities they are produced in the form of, you can say, in the form of food, clothes. And in fact, I would say mine was a secure childhood, both materially and emotionally. And what he has said that his childhood was, you can say, complete one. Why it was a complete one? Because he has got all the requirements of his life in his childhood. Moreover, emotionally it was. Why it was emotionally? It is because of the reason he has got enough love and affection from his parents, from his brothers and sisters. So this is what we have read about APJ Abdul Kalam, about his childhood. So we have read about his father, Jainuddin, his mother, Ashi Amma. They both were quite generous and kind in their nature, feeding number of people who require food and who need help. And he has also made a special mention about his house, that he was living in an ancestral house, which was made up of limestone and bricks. And his father, who was austere in nature, who is always giving importance to the important or the basic necessities of life, but he has never given importance to luxury, right? So this is all for today that we have read. Tomorrow we will continue with the chapter.